Hello, good evening everyone. Welcome to Insights SA Initiative Perspectives. Today's topic is pandemics such as COVID-19, coronavirus disease 19, though catastrophic, are in the end meant to reset humanity and its priorities. It is something I myself coined the statement. So myself, Vinay Kumar GB, founder and director of InsightsIAS. Hopefully, you are aware of our 75 days revision plan, which is going to start in 1 hour, 50 minutes. So do follow the plan. You can visit the website. Now, coming back to today's essay topics. So what are the new perspectives that you can provide in your essay? What are the dimensions which you can use to enrich your essay? So we will see how you can write a better essay for this topic. I directly go on to substantiate with n number of examples that of course these pandemics will reset humanity and its priorities. So you will give 10 examples just to substantiate that as it will reset humanity in XYZ manner and its priorities in XYZ manner. So that is very linear way of writing essay without arousing curiosity or interest in the mind of the reader. So in its entirety, that you will have to write more on how it is going to reset humanity and humanity's priorities to understand that. So before that, the context, pandemics are not new to 21st century. They have been there since human history, but here is a slide which shows that the pandemic which cost too many highest number of human lives to the least number. So coronavirus somewhere stands here, and this is a black death or bubonic plague, nearly killed 200 million people. So at that time we didn't have any vaccines or anything. So today we have vaccines, we have all kinds of research going on, genome related everything. So despite that, we have nearly 5,000 deaths, and WHO has declared coronavirus as pandemic. So just to understand the context, also note the key words here. The plague originated in rats, and now we know that the coronavirus kind of originated in Wuhan in China from wild animals, the kind of animals they eat. And many influenza flu, they have almost originated from animals, bats, rats, pigs, birds, such kind of animals. So why is it important knowing the context? So this itself will give you a new perspective. So what is a perspective? The unusual way of looking into the topic. So looking into the topic, you know the context here. So you can think of an idea such as, is it that a way of nature to punish humanity? Like, these are originating from animals. So we have been indiscriminately killing animals, killing nature, biodiversity, everything, and exploiting resources in an unimaginable scale. So can you think of a perspective where you can start in the introduction saying that, is it a nature's sweet revenge against humanity? Or you can think of a perspective where, you as a human being desire for such kind of pandemic because the planet is overpopulated, because humanity must be taught a lesson about its place in the planet, something like that. And then there are other perspectives like, conspiracy, something related to conspiracy theories. So conspiracy theories, so is it a bioweapon or is it a mistake of a stupid scientist, a brilliant scientist in some lab who wanted to create something, but it let it free into the world. We have such kinds of movies also. And you can think about these conspiracy theories, but you will have to deny them in your essay, because without concrete facts, you cannot just write about them conclusively. And then the kind of social and economic structures we have around the world. So what is their contribution to these pandemics? Are they fueling these pandemics? And with respect to climate change, with respect to globalization, with respect to all kinds of exploitations, and also inequality and poverty and lack of access to quality healthcare, how all of these are fueling pandemic. You know, they are aiding the speedier transmission of diseases like coronavirus, novel coronavirus, and such kind of perspective you will have to think beforehand and keep ready. You should also think about perspectives like the relationship between pandemics and women, pandemics and poverty, pandemics and other vulnerable people, old people, refugees, and so people who are subjected to many kind of atrocities in civil war like situations and dictatorships or some authoritarian regimes. Think of that perspective, and also the global perspective. How so pandemic is itself a global phenomenon affecting multiple countries. So how should all countries come together and fight such kind of pandemic? So we see that WHO or other similar UN organizations might be at the forefront, but there is no concerted international effort. Recently our Prime Minister Narendra Modi started something within the SAARC, but similar at the international level it is lacking. So why is it lacking? So why is it not a priority? So you should have to ask, you will have to ask such kind of questions and try to find answers. And then there is something related to biosecurity, biosafety also. So think from all these angles, you will find so many dimensions to write in your essay. Once you start writing your essay, after writing the introduction, never forget to differentiate and define basic keywords that are there in the topic: endemic, epidemic, pandemic. Doing this exercise will give you clarity to write your essay in proper context. Otherwise, you will be using wrong words in wrong places, in wrong arguments. To write this essay, to understand very well the consequences of pandemics, how they will affect economies, economic structures, trade relations, relationship between countries, between communities, how it is going to affect national security, livelihood of people, lives of people, aspirations of people, and how they are going to cause human suffering, so how they are going to affect transport networks. And their relationship between, as earlier told, climate change, globalization, and all other such things. So consequences, as earlier seen, it can be deaths of millions of people, and loss of millions of jobs, and loss of billions of dollars. It can be trillions of dollars. Now we are seeing how markets are crashing, how prices are varying, and how people are losing jobs, especially tourism industry, and how governments are forced to spend too much on health. Not their priority earlier. Now the priority is to spend too much on health. We saw in China they built an hospital in 10 days. So earlier, in a period of leisure and when there were no diseases, it could have taken 1 year, 2 years. Now they are doing in 10 days. The same human beings, the same government with the same resources. So understanding these kind of urgencies and emergencies that are created by pandemics, you will have to write in essay how, or whether, it's an extreme statement, resetting humanity, what does it mean? So resetting humanity, the meaning of reset is set in a different level, set differently. So resetting alarm, you have set it for 5 a.m. in the morning, then again you are resetting it at 8 a.m. So the priority has changed here. So here resetting humanity means eliminating all of humanity, resetting the planet itself. So that is one interpretation. And another interpretation is that if there are unimaginable number of deaths, and if humanity changes its way of living, it will reset itself, in the sense that there will be so much flourishing of natural vegetation, biodiversity, you know, number of wild animals. Like, it's an hypothetical situation that you don't have to write too much about it. The essay should be mainly concentrated writing about reset of humanity's priorities. So in your opinion, what should be the number one priority, you know, post pandemics like this? So if you think from the perspective of the government, example, government of India, it should be about more of sanitation. We have Swachh Bharat, maybe on war footing, more of health expenditure, you know, spend more than 3% or 4 or 5% of GDP on the health, you know, make it accessible, available, affordable for each and everyone. And then the priorities, you know, within an individual, how we should socialize and how we should consume resources. So we accumulate too much of resources individually with disregard for others, and we have individually disregard for our surrounding environment, to our towards our climate, towards our nature as a whole. So how the priorities must change. And as a community also, how we treat each other, you know, we have to eradicate poverty, all the discriminations, because nothing is local nowadays. Any community, if it gets affected with one particular disease, it can transmit to other parts of the world very fast because of globalization. So we are not living in silos or in, you know, isolation. Keeping this in mind, so the policies or the priorities of individuals or policies of government should eliminate towards, should be targeted towards eliminating all kinds of discriminations, inequalities. Now also there is this perspective of protectionism. Should pandemics lead to more protectionism? Some people argue that, you know, if we protect our borders, if we protect our communities, if we protect our homes, we will not be exposed to such kind of diseases in the future. You can write one or two paragraphs. Mostly you will have to argue against this, because man is a social animal. Howsoever you try to isolate, it will never happen. So we are bound to socialize, and what kind of responsible socialization should be there. And now the concept of social distancing is very famous because of the coronavirus. So how long people should distance themselves? What should be the priority here? So like this, go on asking different questions, and think of priorities at global level, national level. At global level, it is about relationship between countries. It's about global treaties that must be implemented by all the countries, especially with respect to climate change, with respect to diseases, with respect to, you know, refugee crisis. So how countries need to take concerted proactive steps to eliminate any kinds of dangers. And then there are threats of bioweapon, you know, biosecurity, biosafety related issues. So what should be the norms about the research, and what kind of limits, what kind of restrictions that should be put in place to avoid any future catastrophe. And in the end, you will have to obviously stress on certain core values. And nowadays, Namaste is famous. Nowadays, yoga is famous. And then there are absurd other things. You can leave out them. So your values means one, we cannot tell that our values are superior to others' values. So the role of traditional values and the best practices, the best things that are available in different cultures, how we can learn from each other, irrespective of religion, caste, race, creed. So those dimensions also you can think of. So it's a very good essay to write, especially it will help you understand the entire issue of coronavirus in a very holistic manner. So try to write from all the dimensions. So wish you all the best. As told earlier, try to follow 75 days insights revision plan. It is designed in such a way that it will force you to solve minimum 50-60 questions that we post, and plus 200 questions from your end every day. So solving 200 plus questions every day will give you so much practice, so much scope to improve skills to do very well in this exam, which is getting tougher every year. So once again, all the best. Thank you very much.